to go bird watching.
What? Bird watching? I thought we were going over to Chevy's.
Well, we're going bird watching. Why else would I be wearing my adventure hat?
That's a Chevy sombrero.
Your point being?
Never mind.
A stork!
That's not a stork.
Storks are quite fascinating creatures. Would you believe that they could fly even though they're heavier than air?
Well, I knew that most birds could fly, but I guess I never really knew how. Then again, I'm hungry, and I don't care.
Well, too bad, because here we go! Before I explain how storks fly, we need to know some basic forces. In flight, there are a few primary ones: lift, drag, thrust, and gravity. Gravity is the attraction of one mass to another. Lift is a force created by the flying object in order to overcome the force of gravity. Thrust is a force to move forward in order to counteract drag, which is the friction of the medium that the object is flying through. In this case, our stork must create lift and thrust to fight against the attraction of Earth's surface and the friction of Earth's atmosphere.
How much force is required to overcome gravity?
I'm so glad you asked! Using a simple conversion, we can determine that it is necessary to generate approximately 23 newtons of force to overcome gravity for the average stork.
So how do storks glide?
Since the top of the wing is curved, the air above is forced to travel a greater distance at the same time as the air below the wing. Therefore, the air above the wing goes faster, which makes the air over the wing have a lower pressure. Thus, the force from the pressure difference, the lift force, increases. When the lift force is greater than or equal to the bird's weight, the bird can fly through the air.
That's kind of confusing.
Did you look at the diagram?
What diagram? Am I supposed to see something?
Well, no, but I'll show you later.
The point is, stork wings are awesome. And as you can see by this scientific diagram, storks have such powerful wings that they can carry away entire human children and then eat them.
That is a complete lie.
You're right. In reality, storks barely exert enough force to keep airborne, and a baby is too much extra weight. They couldn't carry a baby at all.
Well, yeah, I guess that makes sense.
They leave the babies for the boogeyman.
Wow, storks fly really fast. I wonder how much it would hurt to be hit by one. Wow, great question. High five!
The amount of damage it would do would be based on the stork's momentum. Assuming that a stork flies for 9 hours per day, and they travel roughly 150 kilometers per day, that means they would travel at an average of 4.63 meters per second. Because the average mass of a wood stork is 2.336 kilograms, the momentum of the average bird at this speed is 10.82 kilogram meters per second. If you were in contact with the stork for a period of 1/10 of a second, the force would be 108.2 newtons.
Wow, storks sure do seem to know quite a lot about physics. It's almost as if they know more than we do.
I'm so glad you asked. Using a simple conversion can determine that it's necessary to generate approximately 23 newtons of force to overcome gravity.
I kind of forgot to refocus the camera.
I just tore it.
Ripped it.
Wait, what?
I ripped the sombrero.
Oh, no.